The Untold documentary series produced by Netflix has produced some great sports documentaries, but their best by far has to be Untold, Crimes and Penalties, which featured the Danbury Trashers. Now, for many people, when they saw the trailer for the series, they were excited. There was the Malice of the Palace, there was Caitlyn Jenner. There was a lot of big names, but one that got often overlooked in the series, and one that I was most excited about on a personal note, being from Connecticut, was this story about the Danbury Trashers. How can I describe this series? I promise I'm not going to spoil anything major for you guys, because I really want you to see it, because it's a great documentary, and personally, for a sports documentary, I think it's the best one I've ever seen in a short form. I would give a slight nod to Last Dance and O.J. Simpson Made in America, just because they were able to hold your attention and tell compelling stories for over 8 hours. And sometimes sports documentaries tend to drag on. You can tell they're trying to add filler. But this one, just when you were starting to get a little comfortable, it would throw something else at you. And you're like, oh, my God, this is... So what are the ingredients that make this such a great documentary? Well, let's just say it's the Sopranos combined with the Mighty Ducks, a hint of Slapshot, and a whole lot of WWE. Now, you might be saying, well, these ingredients don't make a lot of sense, but I promise you when you put them together, it grabs you from the beginning and doesn't let go. So I'll give you the basic story, which on the surface doesn't even sound possible. James Galanti was the head of automated waste disposal based in Danbury, Connecticut, and it was one of the largest waste management companies on the entire Eastern Seaboard. He decided to buy a hockey team in the United Hockey League, which was a minor league level. Basically, it's the NHL, the AHL, and really it was the UHL back in the day. This happened between 2004 and 2006. So he bought a United Hockey League team, but he didn't just buy it for himself. He put his son in charge of the team as the president, which doesn't seem abnormal until you find out his son was 17 at the time and had just finished high school. You're going, wait a minute, what? There is something going on here. But the funny thing is, his son did a great job building the team. The team was highly competitive and even in their second season made it to the league finals. But it wasn't just they were good. They had an identity. They were the bad boys of hockey. Think of, if you're an old school hockey fan, think of the enforcers on the team, then just multiply them, because this team was full of not only enforcers, which was great because this team would get in fights all the time. It wasn't just fights. They would have 8 fights a night, and it wasn't just fights. Before the first game, the owner, Galanti, he called down to the bench on a cell phone and told their new enforcer, hey, puck drops, go beat someone up. You're like, oh, my God. And then James Galanti was being confronted by a ref about the fights. He punches the referee in one of these games. It was just absolute bedlam. Now, you may be saying, well, what's the hook of this story? Does the name AJ sound familiar for a famous TV show? Oh, yeah, The Sopranos. Well, it turns out many people have said that this is the family that inspired the Sopranos series, and you can see all the similarities, and they had a connection with the mafia. So not only do you get Goodfellas, The Sopranos, and The Mob, but you basically get the movie Slapshot and Goon with steroids on ice. And the fans of Danbury absolutely loved this team. People don't realize Connecticut has a passionate hockey fan base. And people go like, oh, Connecticut, well, they had a professional team till 1997 with the Whalers and then they left. But this state loves hockey, whether it's minor league hockey, more recently, college hockey. This is a hockey state, and people don't understand that. And you could see how passionate and crazy this fan base was in the documentary. They had a section named 102, and one of my favorite fans is He literally brings a truck horn into the games. And because the section is right behind the visitor's bench, he's blowing a truck horn during every moment that they're trying to talk. It was hysterical. And the first reaction when you meet AJ, you're like, why would someone give this kid, this 17-year-old kid that loves wrestling? He came off a little bit of arrogant and a bit of a punk. But then when you watch the rest of the documentary, you find out, like they say this whole time, they wanted a team where you root for the bad guys. And then you look at the guys who are in charge of this team, you're rooting for them. You're like, I know that their family's involved in stuff, but you want to see them succeed. There's just something about them that draws you in, and you can't really explain it. But anyways, you have a league that hated what this team was doing, then eventually turned to love what this team was doing. This team would take advantage, and you could easily make a case with the 2005-2006 NHL lockout. And I'm not kidding you about this. In the United States, this might have been the hottest ticket in hockey. You had a lot of people and sellouts and people scalping tickets for a minor league hockey game. That doesn't happen, ladies and gentlemen. Usually you can't give tickets away to minor league hockey games. In this situation, people were scalping them out the door. That's how popular this team became. But this whole time, you have this crazy hockey team with crazy characters where if you were to tell me to write a hockey comedy or a slapshot-like comedy and come up with characters, you couldn't come up with these characters if you were given 100 times to try. I mean, I'm not going to ruin all of them, but one of my favorite ones is they had a guy with one eye. I'm not kidding you. They had a one-eyed hockey player. And then they had two brothers, like the Hanson brothers from the movie Slapshot. And the best part is you can tell that these guys love each other, but they annoy the hell out of each other all the time. It is hysterical watching these two on camera. And you could just feel that not only was this a team that people love to watch or people love to hate, but this team really became a family, and just how this whole thing ends is just crazy. And even we're 15 years later, we're still talking about this team, and this team still has a passionate fan base. And even players are still getting recognized saying, oh, I remember you playing for the Danbury Trashers. It's just crazy. And to me, like I said, this is one of the best documentaries I've ever seen. From the start to the finish, it is just entertaining, and it does something that great movies do, and that's make you root for the bad guys. I mean, if you watch Goodfellas, if you watch the movie Casino, if you watch any of these old school mob movies, the great ones, you root for the bad guy. And in this documentary, you find yourself going, I didn't like these guys in the beginning, but the more you hear from the players and from the community, you're like, wow, these guys, they're incredible. Like what they were able to do in a short amount of time. It's not easy building any hockey team. And then on top of that, you see AJ go from this 17-year-old kid giving a hockey team. You're like, oh. And you go, of course, and you roll your eyes like, of course, rich daddy gives his kid like the keys to the Ferrari and he's going to run into the ground. But despite his lack of experience and lack of knowledge in the job, you give AJ a lot of credit because not only did he build a good team with limited knowledge. I mean, think about it. There are guys that spend 30 to 40 years in this business in trying to build the team, and they can't do it. And what he was able to do with limited knowledge, limited resources, I mean, we're talking about in 2004, 2005, I mean, YouTube was barely a thing then. It wasn't like you could just look up video for hockey players. But more importantly, he knew what he wanted his team to be, what he wanted their identity to be, and he did it. He built a team around the identity that he wanted, and they were highly successful. And to me, I think that's the underrated part of the story, because AJ was 17 at the time, and you see his growth within this documentary, but also you see that he was creative and he really understood the one thing that people almost don't like to say about minor league sports, but it's entertainment. I mean, minor league sports, like, yes, sports is what gets people interested, but how you keep bringing people back is being entertained. That's why you see all these gimmicks at minor league baseball games, at minor league hockey games. But this was a team that their gimmick wasn't necessarily giving out weird promotions or crazy jerseys. It was giving people colorful characters that they would fall in love with and want to come back and support. And you have to give them a lot of credit. So all in all, this, I have to give this an A+. This was once again one of the best sport documentaries I have ever seen. Go watch this on Netflix. You will be thoroughly entertained. If you love hockey, if you love wrestling, if you love the mob, heck, if you just like rooting for the bad guys in a movie, you're going to love this documentary. So highly recommend it. Go check it out on Netflix and go watch this. And of course, let me know in the comments, what were your thoughts about this documentary? What grade would you give it? Is it one of the best ones you've ever seen? Is there anything missing from it that you would have liked to seen? Make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our latest content. And hey, this is one of my first reviews. If you want me to do more reviews on sports content, whether it be documentaries, movies, let me know and I will do that. I want to give you guys what you want to see. But until next time, I'm Nolan Rich and this is Rich Sports Talk.